IVM.
कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, the language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative. You know, this show, Cyrus says, now we are getting people on who are very close to God spiritually. I'm telling you honestly. For me, it's very important that they profit as well as they're close to God. But otherwise, I don't believe in people. I don't believe anyone is that holy. And I'm getting them one after another, which I can't believe. There are very few of them, but we are getting them all. We've got a very interesting guest. I won't disclose who yet because I first want to vent about my problems. And wo problem hai ki toilet culture in Mumbai, it's not improving. I've noticed, I just went to use the public urinal in the office area and you have to open and lock with a key for some reason. The guy inside took more than 4 minutes to come out. 4 minutes and 50 seconds I watched on the phone clock. And I must say that I think there should be a limit. We should allow 3 minutes for males to urinate. And I keep in mind the prostate issue and all that. So let's look at it properly. 15 to 25 age group, they pee in 30-40 seconds. Bar again. After that, 30 to 40-45 prostate initial issues, fair enough, give them till 2-2.5 minutes. And then I'm willing to go up to 3 minutes for elderly people because I know myself, sometimes it takes long to start. The engine doesn't work, you know, winter and all that. These things happen. But more than 3 minutes is ridiculous. And the guy needs to be hospitalized immediately. Why make us wait outside for hours? So electroshock therapy can be applied in toilets. It can be attached to the area like a sensor that when you cross the 3-minute mark, ping, you get shock. And 3 minutes, 30 seconds, stronger shock. And 4 minutes and above, you just shock the guy completely so he can't pee for days out of the shock. This is my humble request, please, people. Let's get together. No longer shall us minorities, and by minorities, I mean people who want to pee in a hurry, have to wait outside. Well, some joker takes 15 minutes to pee and then 20 minutes to wash both his hands, having used only one finger. Woh alag baat hai. I won't come into that today because I don't want to waste a guest's time. He's already angry at this rubbish he has to hear.
Do you wonder why China does the things that it does? Or want to know how we could improve online privacy? Or perhaps you're thinking about how we can kickstart India's economy? If you'd like to search for the answers to such questions, check out All Things Policy, a daily public policy podcast that covers everything from employment figures to aircraft carriers. Tune in from Monday to Friday for new episodes and fresh takes.
Let's bring in our entrepreneur, who's an entrepreneur with a heart. And this is not just a cliche. Like I said, we've been running into many of them. All that are there in India, they are going to be on these podcasts. So let's call in Mr. Hitesh Dhingra. He's the co-founder and MD of The Man Company. I will go back in time and tell you this man is successful not once, not twice, not three times, but many times over. And most of us, we hope that we get karma in this lifetime to do well once in our business or whatever career choice we have. This is a man, like a few that have featured here, who is basically just great at doing things. And he also has the ability to make people happy while doing things. So it's not just a business, it's a business with heart. We'll come to that in a second. Hitesh, this is a tribute to you, this entire show. We are chelas and we bring people on. We never take them on. This is not some, what is that, Karan Thapar style or Arnab Goswami rather of today style of the show. So we only want to tell you how great you are and what a fantastic journey it's been. I'm going to start right at the beginning. In fact, I want to go back before we come to The Man Company. You first started a series of startups. The first famous one was Let'sBuy.com. So can we first go back into your life and then of course we'll focus completely on The Man Company. Kaisa hua, kab hua, and how did Hitesh become the businessman firstly and the entrepreneur?
Yeah. So first of all, Cyrus, thanks for having me here in this show today. No better way to start a day with a good laugh, and especially with you. I just hope you're not making bakra of me. I think spend my early teens watching MTV Bakra. Not early teens, but late teens. But
yes, yeah. Claims to be younger than anchor. Something that should be discussed before the show, pre-show. Next time I shave karke aega. I have less too much white muesli growth on my chin.
Not more than mine, so don't worry.
But you look nice with it. I just look old. Yeah. People have started calling me uncle everywhere I go now. I'm dreading the other word, the D word that's coming next. Sorry. Great. Let's go back.
Yeah. So Let's Buy was my kind of plunge into entrepreneurship. Before Let's Buy, I was working in this company in Singapore, which was into IT distribution. So we used to distribute products for, brands like Apple, Microsoft, IBM, etc. So I think what I realized was, even though Apple back then was doing more than $1 billion sales from Apple.com in US, India mein, there was no brand selling online, right? So there were few e-commerce platforms which were like marketplaces, wahan pe second-hand products zyada bikte the, or new products were very less. So there was a lot of issue around credibility and people were not comfortable buying, let's say, a mobile phone online, right? So they were probably buying books and stuff, but not expensive products like mobile phones or laptops.
Sex products. Hitesh, I think sex products sold online. This is one thing I remember.
Yeah. And sex toys in the at that too secondhand, right? So there was no credibility around that as well.
Who buys secondhand sex products?
Because it was a marketplace model, right? And that's what I think I realized that we need to get these brands online, build credibility around e-commerce. And that's what kind of excited me to launch Let's Buy, which was kind of India's first e-commerce player selling only electronics, mobile phones, etc. So ran it for kind of 2.5 years and then got acquired by Flipkart.
So before, obviously, they realized that you have so much potential and you've hit the right notes and all that. You were saying ki there was no culture of buying online. I'm trying to remember 2009, not that far back, but I can't remember properly. Then what gave you the confidence ki, you know, people are going to start buying electronics to begin with and all that? Because obviously, you could see the future in a sense. So where did that confidence come from?
Yeah, so I knew. So I had a very short stint with an online advertising agency where I was managing accounts like eBay, India Times, Make My Trip, Monster. Right. And I knew that eBay was selling one mobile phone every 3 minutes. Right. Today, I think there are a few thousand every minute. But eBay was selling one mobile phone every 3 minutes. Right. And that kind of struck with me that people are buying mobile phones, even though I think there is so much lack of trust, credibility. That time, using your credit card online was not considered safe, right? Even Make My Trip used to offer cash on delivery on air tickets, imagine, right? So today, I think it all sounds like ki aisa bhi hota tha, but yes, I remember spending a day at ICICI's office just to enable payment gateway on our website, right? Because it was so difficult to get hold on. But that's what the realization was here. Ki, matlab, log khareed to rahe hain, they are spending, but still, I think it's a very, very small population. And considering India is a huge country, every state is like a country, right? And the logistics, obviously, we've made a lot of progress in the last 10 years, but then was a challenge. Accessibility was a challenge. So my sister, who was in Ajmer, she couldn't buy a laptop online or offline because it was just not available, right? So Dell, HP were not available in Ajmer till like 5-7 years back, right? And or probably 10 years back when we started. That was, I think, the use case. Whenever I used to pitch to investors, I think that's what I used to tell them.
Personal note is always the best.
Exactly. Ajmer mein, you can't buy an HP laptop. So that was the huge pain point that we were solving for, right? So accessibility plus building the trust, convenience, all of that combined.
But you know what makes Hitesh Dhingra stand out from the rest? Obviously, and it's simple, but it's like, again, I come back to Shehwag's batting or something. Everybody knows it's simple, but you can't do it yourself. One is that you're able to see what the supply is, what the market demand is, and then you bring that supply into play. And secondly, you're able to see the future. Like you had the ability to know that the credit card payments will happen, online payments will happen, online will overtake. And then, of course, pandemic must have just accelerated everything. But you had that ability to understand what's happening in the future, which is not necessarily just from experience. It's just like innate business sense and acumen. So I don't want you to comment on that because I know then you have to praise yourself. Do drink ke baad wo theek hai. Normally it's not nice. So we'll move a little ahead. Then you obviously did well and you decided you'll flip the company to Flipkart.
Yes. So Flipkart ended up acquiring Let's Buy in 2012.
And once you've tasted blood there, obviously you're not going to stop. You moved on to trulymadly.com at a time, I think, when there already were a few there. So you still felt that the dating app and all is here to stay. And so you went with this. Tell us about that a little bit.
Yeah. So in fact, TrulyMadly, when we started out 2013, there were hardly any dating apps. So Tinder was not there in India. Tinder, I think in US had started in 2012-13. And Tinder was more like casual dating, right? More of a hookup app. Back then,
if you want
now,
to call it that, sir, or be Gandhi Shav there, but that's fine.
idea with, I think, TrulyMadly was that India mein there were matchmaking portals like Shaadi Bharat Matrimony on one side doing a great job, but mostly marriage focus. And I think what we realized was, again, wahan pe bhi thoda wo personal aaya. So a lot of my cousins, right? They were like 27, 28 year old female women. They were not registering themselves on these websites. It was their parents or their elder sibling,
correct,
brother,
yeah.
right? And they were managing correct the account because they didn't want to share the contact details, right, of the girl. So there were a lot of pain points that we figured out ki yaar, jo existing matchmaking sites hain, they never had an app. So wahan pe jo challenges the, especially for women. So we wanted to build something which is one, women first, right? So that women feel very, very comfortable. So there were obviously kind of some check, reference check, etc., ID check, etc., before you create your account. We were weeding out married men from the platform as well. So we had a small team.
People like me, the creepy old uncles were being thrown out slowly. We were able to see through that. But just put it on record. Sorry to interrupt, but 2012 ki baat hai, that trulymarried.com came in and did more for women empowerment, because literally the woman is now controlling the date in a sense. Then well before Rahul Gandhi made it popular with the interview he did in 2014. So yeah, that's again, see, we're able to see the trend there, that you're able to predict, that give women the power in the dating world or dating business. Nobody's seen it from that perspective till then. So again, you score a point immediately. So I think people should just follow your career, try to figure out what you're doing, and then understand where the success will lie.
And do it better.
No one will do it better. So, and you also pull out at the right time, not to use a pornographic phrase, but it's clear. So then, now we are coming to the main story, which is why we are here, the man company. Magar, Kintu, Parantu. You sold this one as well, trulymarried.com?
No, it is still there. So I operationally exited from the business, but yeah, it is still doing well.
And so you sorry to ask personal question, but your equity is there, or you have just moved out completely?
Yes, equity is there, but operationally I'm not involved. I exited like 5-6 years back.
So just a last point on this, obviously dating app, there's no end to it, because the next generation comes into play. It's not like something else which is like a fad. So what happens is you're just, you know, it's just a cycle. Or uske baad next cycle. Fair enough. So now, why did you turn your head to the man company? Again, we'll discuss this in detail. It looks like you were able to see market demand and supply, which is not there. So, but where does it come from, your idea, sir? Love to know.
Yeah. So again, while running Truly Madly, we used to have this focus group called Chai Pe Charcha, right? So Modi ji ki Chai Pe Charcha started.
Bahut nazdeek aa gaya line of control pe, sir ji. Back off.
So we used to do a lot of these focus groups, especially with women, right? And we used to go to MBA colleges, etc., just to understand their pain points, let them experience any new product feature that we were about to launch. I think one pain point that we figured out was ki yaar, men high bol ke chale jaate the, right? Uske baad, matlab, they didn't know how to kind of continue the conversation, right?
What are you saying? And, you're right.
And so women, and uske baad, they used to wonder ki yaar, main bar bar high likh raha hu, mere ko reply ki nahi aa raha, right? Because matlab, they didn't know how to kind of continue with the conversation. So we realized ki yaar, ek to overall grooming thoda India mein, agar hume dating culture banana hai, to overall grooming to thodi karni padegi, right? Which will be more like education, right? And how do you kind of impart education without being cheating?
So basically, how to not be a Dehati? That's basically what you're actually saying. Yeah.
Exactly. So let's say if you're going on a first date, how to behave, what to order, what not to order, kaisi jagah pe jana chahiye, kaise kapde pehna chahiye, and all of that, right? And then conversation vagera. So we launched something called Miss TM, right, which was more like an assistant to help you with tips, dating tips, etc., etc. But usse ek ye aaya ki yaar, log jab first date pe aa rahe the aur jab wo picture mein jo dikhte hain, they were very, very different, right? So they were not at all groomed, right? Nails bade hue hain ya matlab whatever, right? So we got multiple feedback. So we realized yaar, matlab ye bhi ek opportunity hai ki matlab yaar, Indian men ko grooming ki to zarurat hai, and not just in terms of what they apply, hairstyling wagera, but overall, right? And can we create a platform which help like Indian men, especially millennials, to kind of elevate them to next level, right? In terms of their career, in terms of how they look, how they behave, who they are, right? And just by being a kind of grooming buddy to them, right? So that's what the vision was. And somehow I think India may, even when we looked at the grooming space in terms of product, we realized that there were not many brands. I think Nivea, Garnier ke do char products the, right? And all women-focused brands, but they had a couple of products for men, but no one was really talking to men as consumers, right? And that's what we wanted to build, to create a brand which is kind of communicating to the millennials in the language that they understand, right? And create products which are like head-to-toe. Ki aapko aaj, आपके बाल हैं नहीं हैं, बट आपको प्रोडक्ट्स तो फिर भी चाहिए. सो मतलब वी हैव प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर बियर्ड एज वेल एज शेव गाइस.
Exactly. It's almost sexism, na? Ki 100-200 years se for women, the products have been there and for women, but nobody ever thought about it for men, really. I mean, Fair and Handsome or Dark and Handsome, whatever that is the only one I remember vaguely.
Yes.
Baki the maybe Vaseline and things like that. I don't know anything else which where there's exactly. Some advertising that crosses over. But so let's not go there. So you that's your hat trick. Again, you understood the market. I think it imbalance with you, Usme, because you've done female grooming in a sense of pushing the female envelope. And then you went back and said males have to be balanced also. So you have to help them. Your point is that Indian males basically need help also. They're a bit of a handicap and they definitely need a hand on the shoulder to help them present themselves, not just for dating, but also for real life. It comes to the same thing, right? When you groom them with all these things, you're giving the personality a push and then obviously to have the self-esteem for everything. So let us now go to the, there's so many interesting things. There are three noteworthy heroes we have to get into quickly. Helmet Man of India, Raghavendra Kumar. Okay, this amazing story will you tell us about? Puts the company on the map.
Yeah. So I think as a brand, what we've realized that we are celebrating gentlemen, right? I think there is so much pressure on today's man, right? To kind of do this, do that, manage this, be perfect, right? 10 on 10. But that's not practically possible, right? And we said, since we are talking to these millennial men, why don't we celebrate them, right? Why don't we celebrate every man? I mean, whether you, me, irrespective of how we look, because agar aap wo gentleman ki definition bhi bologe Google pe, toh you'll figure out, matlab, there's this suited, booted guy with a black tie, etc., right? But that's not true, right? So gentleman means what values you have within, right? So we said, and every guy has some good values, right? Why don't we celebrate those values? So this is what we have been doing for last few years. As a brand, we celebrate gentlemen. And I think the Helmet Man you spoke about is kind of extension of the brand tone that we have, what we stand for. And he is an extraordinary gentleman. He lost one of his friends in a road accident, right? Because he was not wearing a helmet. And he decided to kind of use all his savings, right, to buy helmets. And if he figured out that someone is driving a two-wheeler without a helmet, he ends up donating them a helmet, right? A small gesture, but you have to look at the passion, right? He has ended up using all his savings just for this cause, to make sure that no one else loses his life riding a two-wheeler without helmet.
It's amazing. In our country, there are so many horrible stories, and then there's one really good one to balance it out completely. So obviously he is going beyond his pocket. It's not like he was a super rich guy.
Exactly. No, and that's what matters, right? And trust me, I think there are so many bad stories, but there are even more number of good stories, but not many people talk about them, right? And for us, I think just because we wanted to celebrate these gentlemen, so it is not just Helmet Man. I think he's doing a great job, but we have also profiled many other, people. And super there are a few in the lineup as well. Exactly. Superhero of Jabalpur. Then there's a guy in Rajasthan, right? He used all his... He's a CA, MBA, left his job in top five companies, auditing companies, and started educating kids in a village in Alwar, right? And he has been running this vocational school free of cost for the village kids, right? And it's not CBSE curriculum. It's all vocational, right? So some of these guys have been doing extraordinary stuff.
So this is Gautam Khandelwal you're talking about?
Yes, this is Gautam Khandelwal.
Okay. And just, sorry, but the superhero of Jabalpur, uska kya exactly kahani hai?
So his life is also similar. So I think he also kind of teaches underprivileged kids and absolutely free of cost. So, and that's what I think he has been doing as a professional. So he's given up on his job, high-paying job, and he has dedicated himself to teach these underprivileged kids in Jabalpur.
And so just quickly take us through what the Man Company does. You're paying homage to them or, basically putting them in the spotlight, creating awareness?
Yes. So I think we're doing two things. One, we wanted to celebrate these gentlemen, their stories, and put them into the spotlight, right? So we do kind of share their stories with over 3 million men who are associated with us across our social media platforms, etc. Second, we have also launched an exclusive product, which is called Honor. Right. So it's a fragrance, and the 10% sales from that particular fragrance goes back to these gentlemen, right, to help them in their cause.
Fantastic. So you are the alternate government, sir, doing the social renovation and reformation that maybe governments forget to do from time to time. chup, don't tell anyone. Nobody watches the show. We are fine. We can discuss all this. But from the same point, if we go into the other things that you all have done, and there are many more folks who are watching, it's not just one or two things. We have only so much time to talk about it. And just see how innovative this entire company and your thought process is, because you are the brand ultimately. The first two-piece charcoal sheet mask, which is actually beard-friendly. As a man with a beard, I think that became a personal issue. Just take us through that first two-piece charcoal sheet mask. What is this?
Look, I think as a consumer product company, I think what we realize is, especially when you're creating a category, right? Men's grooming, matlab men, just like you mentioned, I mean, you probably knew about Fair and Handsome and probably some deodorant brands, right? Apart from that, there was nothing much. You end up using the same product that women of the house gets, right? Or is using, right?
Be the until they find out. Until they find out.
Until they find out, right? So I think that's where we realize that one is the education part to create awareness. And second is the product innovation part. Right. We as a brand need to understand our consumers really, really well. Right. So, and that requires a lot of innovation. So whatever we launch is kind of innovation because no one else has done it. Right. Because no one was catering to this segment anyways. Right. So sheet mask, there are a lot of sheet masks for women. But if you have a beard, and I think 40-50% of India population today, especially millennial men, would have a beard. You just can't apply that mask. Right. Because it doesn't stick on your beard. Right. So we ended up launching this two-piece sheet mask, right, which is beard friendly. So you can apply in the non-bearded part and it works perfectly fine. Right. So similarly, we've done a lot of these product innovations over years just because we try to understand our consumers better.
Why did I think of this beard mask here? This is a huge market. I can't believe it. Throughout the pandemic, I'm thinking, what can I get into business with which will 100% work for the next year or so to begin with? Fabulous thinking. Then you have this, what is it? Lighting lip balm? Lighting.
Yeah, so this is a lip lightening balm. So basically, I mean, if you are a smoker, so your lips end up turning darker, right? I mean, black, right? So I think this lip balm is nothing but licorice. It is 100% natural and it kind of lightens up your lips, right? So it comes with a lip scrub as well. So you just apply scrub and it's a sugar, brown sugar scrub. So you just apply scrub and then use lip balm. And over a period of time, you see the, I think, whatever smoke, which is kind of, which has darkened your lips and it kind of goes away.
Hitesh, I have to interrupt you. You'll expect a call from a guy called Mr. Samir Wankhede. You have mentioned brown sugar twice in the last 5 minutes. Okay, I'm just telling you. I can't control these guys in Mumbai. They have nothing to do. They'll just call you for time pass. Just give them a lip balm.
Unrefined sugar.
Unrefined sugar. It's not the same thing. People are getting excited, waking up and saying, brown sugar. This is the web podcast for them. So many other things. Can't get into everything, but I want to get into two more points before we take a break. One is the International Men's Day campaign. Is it true that there's an International Men's Day? I thought it's like a joke because I know there's a Women's Day. I didn't know they have a Man's Day as well. Or have you created this?
No one was celebrating it. It has existed for years, but somehow I think in India, no brand was celebrating men. So that's why no one was celebrating International Men's Day. So we thought, why don't we be the first one to kind of celebrate? So we had launched our first campaign 3 years back with Ayushman Khurana, and that kind of went crazily viral. And after that, I mean, every year we have been doing something or the other. So last year, I mean, we launched this campaign called Tumito, Gentlemen Tumito, right? So which again went viral because it was celebrating the next door gentleman, right? And almost, I think everyone. So we shot this video in a day's time during lockdown, but kind of worked really well.
Yeah, this could also work with the Aam Aadmi Party because you're trying to say everyone is sort of the same, left and right. Hum sab ek hai. So Ayushman Khurana is the brand ambassador. And what is the date of the International Men's Day? I know March 7th or something is the Women's Day or 8th.
Yeah, so this is 19th September. 8th March is Women's Day, but 19th September is Men's Day.
So for baki genders, jo hai, I think there are about 94 more identified genders. Do they all get one day each in the LGBTQ RST group?
No, ideally should. Fair. I think ideally brand should celebrate every day, right? Why not? I think every day should be a celebration.
Aap toh ek businessman ho. I think for you, everything is, it's a very clinical thing in the sense ki, yeah, I'm finding the market and I'm, you know, then it's not judgment about who they are exactly, etc.
Yes,
so
yes,
why not? Yes. 94 more days of celebration. Each one becomes an event and an epic and you can really
Why not? China has this Singles Day, which is kind of, I mean, the biggest shopping festival that they have.
Kya day? Single?
Singles Day.
What single? They're the most overpopulated country in the world. Kaan se angle se single hai? This is nonsense.
No, that's why they are celebrating whatever singles are left in the country.
Oh, okay. Before they get wiped out completely. Fair enough. Yeah. So, but you know, we are joking about this, but this is exactly the innovation and ideas which seem to work sometimes. It's exactly how this whole company has come through. You first were going towards the women empowerment side almost in this dating app, and you've gone completely to the other side to say men have been forgotten. And actually, when it comes to grooming and beauty and just personality influencing and all that, I don't know. But nobody else has really thought about it to help Indian men. And God knows we need help. The toilet ki baat hai. So I'll explain the whole situation to you again. You don't know how people behave. Please do something about the toilet grooming also. Why do they, Hitesh, why do men take so long to wash their hands? I don't know about Delhi, I'm talking about Mumbai. They finish their pee, then they go to the basin, then 5 minutes, what the hell do they do that for here? Full bath, no, up to the forearm.
No, it's the other way around in Delhi. So Delhi, mein you have to teach them how to wash. Because they don't.
I'm coming. I'm happy. I'd rather they don't wash. What is this wash for half an hour? Bella, it's not chota. Let me put this choti baat hai. All you have to do is use 1 or 2 fingers. Why are you acting like a man? I've used both my hands and my leg and my elbow and all just to pee. Don't answer that, sir. International Toilet Days and Men's Day, same day. Himisha, who's listening to the show. Yeah. Is that true? No, sir, right. I've given you an idea.
I wasn't aware, but yes, I think if it is, then we should definitely celebrate.
Kuch karna padega. So Ayushman Khurrana is on. I have one complaint against him. He's a good friend, actually, junior from the MTV studios. And he has gone online to talk about protein powders and say they're very dangerous and they don't get digested for 1 year. So Hitesh, when you renew his contract, please tell him that this is nonsense. And he cannot talk like this about protein powders and stick to grooming. Theek hai. Let's talk a little bit of what's there in the future now with the company. Any new innovative products to be launched? Anything that's in your head? Any as you took advantage of the pandemic in a sense with the beard thing? Tell us what.
I think a lot of innovation. We recently launched this product, which is under eye gel with a massager. Right. So considering all of us have been spending so much time in front of screens, I mean, whether for work or Netflix or whatever, I think almost everyone has got those dark circles. Right. So this is just to help you out with your dark circles. And it's a pretty cool thing. I think it has all of a sudden become my favorite product from our overall portfolio, and 100% natural again. But you just apply a bit of gel and then use the roller to massage your dark circles.
So Hitesh, tell us, it's a slightly, I know, secretive question and answer, fair enough. But do you test this amongst your own people every time? How do you know what like with the people around you, you get the feedback from them? How do you do it?
No, we've got a very good kind of 120 odd people focus group. Right. And they are like our loyal customers who have been buying from us for last 6 years. So whenever we launch a product, we generally kind of share the samples before launch with them for their feedback. And based on their feedback, whatever changes it requires, we do that and then finally launch it. Right. So and even before sharing it with them, it is generally, I mean, me and some of my colleagues, teammates, we use a specific product for more than a month, right? And only if we want to kind of wake up every morning and use that product, then we launch it. Otherwise, we don't.
I'm going to share something with you because I've got a very innovative mind. You won't believe it. And ek cheez hai ki I find the chairs ka hand of the chairs are too small. We need to make them longer so that when you go forward also, you're still there, you know, resting. These are little things, but I'm giving you this as my gift. I'm telling it will sell very, very well because now we are stuck, as you said, always in front of the screen, always stuck on a chair. So the movement of the body is restricted anyway. So why remove the comfort of the hand? The hand should be longer. So I'll fall off now.
I completely agree. So I'll keep that idea in mind when I'm doing the furniture company.
There you go. 50-50, sir. 50-50 equity. I am always transparent and straight up, just like the government. Ting, ting. Okay. don't get Hitesh involved in any controversy. Although Chai Pe Charcha was the very first thing we mentioned for some reason, and there are two applicants now. If you Google, it's not just the Prime Minister talking to you, it may very well be Hitesh, who may one day be Prime Minister, in which case you solve the problem. Let's get on board our producer, a young man. This is the guy for you. He's in his 20s and he's from that generation. I believe my generation, I would like to say the word Ganda generation to some extent, because you know we don't even understand grooming, but you've caught the millennials and after. So, Silvery, if you can come on, Silvery is taking a season power, it takes a little longer. Silvery, you have to unmute yourself. It's a technology thing you guys taught us.
Huh. Yes, before that, we have a break, Cyrus.
We have a break. So, Hitesh, we have 30 seconds where you can relax. Here's the break.
Hey, everybody. It's been another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. On Think Fast, Varun and Suchita start off the new year with a deep dive into hybrid working models, the bustling creator economy, and end with some insights from the movie business. The Simplified Gang decode what Web3 and NFTs are with Eklavya Bhattacharya, an expert in the space. On the Airball Diaries, Monisha Nishant are joined by comedian Ashish Shakya. They discuss their introduction to the world of the NBA and what got them hooked. On Probation Se Promotion Tak, Abhinav answers the age-old career question, passion or stability. And on the Life Manifesto, Zarina teaches us the much-needed art of decluttering. Do follow us on social media. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And remember, if you're enjoying this show or any of our other shows for that matter, please do tell a friend. Also, don't forget to rate us on any of the platforms you're listening to us on. And you can also check us out on YouTube. You can have a list of all of our shows at ivmpodcast.com/YouTube. And finally, we'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Bank of Baroda and CoinSwitch Kuber.
Anyway, welcome back to Groom Barabar Groom. Silvery?
Yes, sir.
Come on, now your generation and the one after yours also, which I think Hitesh is basically targeted. You guys are much cleaner and careful about all these things. So what are your observations about male grooming and the importance of what his market that he has created?
So I am very often nowadays in rooms where everyone has beards. And it's more often than not nowadays. So I think...
And these are women, huh? Hitesh, these are women.
Yes, sure. So I think beard grooming is like huge among men. So I want to ask Hitesh, what is like the biggest tip you can give someone who's like growing a beard or trying to maintain a good beard or something?
So look, I'm not an expert when it comes to grooming. I'm expert when it comes to marketing the grooming products, but still I'll try my best. When you want to grow a beard, and someone like Cyrus, if he wants to grow a beard, for first like first 2-3 weeks, he won't like it, right? Because he'll feel the itchiness and it doesn't look tidy, right? And someone who's been shaving like every second day or whatever. But I think first 3 weeks, you need to control your mind and let it grow, right? And once you have a decent enough stubble, then obviously I think you just need to kind of nourish it using beard oil so that, I mean, you have a proper growth, dense growth. And I think once you have grown it big enough, then you can probably apply styling products like beard wax, etc. But otherwise, I think just the normal nourishing with beard oil and just washing it with beard shampoo is good enough.
Sir, hota to nahi. Maine bahut koshish kiya life mein. It just doesn't grow properly. Yaar, yahan se, wahan se. I just look like that. I don't know if you've seen a movie called Fu Manchu. You know, it's a very strange growth, yaar. And, people, they just laugh at me and make fun. Sir, I just don't have.
Sir, a couple of days back, you had like a bit of a stubble, and you got a lot of comments. You got a lot of comments saying that you look really good in that.
That's because 8 days I didn't shave, but that's the best. That it doesn't become thick and all like your beard. I've never had that. Okay. No, yaar.
No, will Saras, let us send you some products.
Oh, color karega. We give me pencils or something. I'll color it in to make it thick. That's the option.
Yeah. So we've got this thing called Derma Roller, right? So it has those micro needles. You apply it, and I mean, if you're having a patchy beard, then it kind of solves for that. So it opens up the pores and kind of get.
I thought he's going to give me testosterone injections or something. He's like, become a man finally. Chuck. Hitesh is too kind. He doesn't.
So injection, but. Yeah, we are working on something like that as well. So hopefully soon.
Oh, wow. See, okay. I'm a genius. Dekha, I was just being silly and dekha.
Wait, this is pure. So that'll help with like hair loss also? Is that what I'm saying?
Hormonal treatment will help with beard growth. I don't know about hair loss.
So we're working on something. So this category will be 100% natural, right? Something like, yes, testosterone booster as well, but 100% natural, right? And a very different, interesting format. So instead of capsules, right? I mean, this is a dissolvable strip. You just put it on your tongue and it gets dissolved, right? So, and it comes in multiple flavors like watermelon, mango, etc., etc. Right? So very easy to consume, 100% natural, no side effect.
I mean, who? What kind of person wants to buy it just for the taste? Yaar, taste badhiya hai, chalo. I mean, in a practical application. But I know for a fact, women who have these testo injections and all that, they start growing facial hair. I know a couple of women who have, for whatever sad reason, had to do it. And then immediately facial hair happens. So I'm convinced if I take one of these injections or whatever treatment, I will get the beard that I've been waiting for. And then I become Hitesh's market. At the moment, I'm on the line. Till he,
we've got shaving products as well. Don't worry.
There you go. तो आ गया मैं लाइन में आ गया वापस. ओके
फॉर एवरी जेंटलमैन.
Fantastic. But see, that's the greatness of this thinking of yours. See, I don't think you ever look at anybody as a negative. Whoever it is, it's a brand, it's a market, it has to be launched in a sense. Yeah. But coming back to what Silver is saying, you can see the difference in generations. Hitesh, you're the expert on this. His generation, the one after that also, they are careful. I can see that in just the way they turn out, whether it's clothes to the way they look and all that. So you can see there's a difference. Why? How come the we guys from my generation don't have that dhyan on the hygiene and beauty products?
Yeah. Look, I think the urge to kind of look good, to feel good is kind of growing, right? And especially thanks to social media. I mean, probably I don't post enough pictures of mine on social media, right? I'm there on Instagram, but just for consumption, right? Whereas, I mean, probably his generation, I mean, they are content creators, right?
All day,
right? So they have to look good as well, right? For their audience.
You can't see his hands right now. He's posting.
Yeah, correct. And hit send.
Yeah. Having a boring chat with two men. I saw that. That's really mean. Yeah. No, but also maybe it's the difference is that we look good naturally and these guys really struggle. So they need you and your products to help them. That could be one of the reasons. Silvery, what do you feel?
Yeah, definitely. So that's what. So like again, like people my age are definitely buying better clothes, like and dressing better. You go out for parties and you see that as a generation we are all
more competitive. All this,
yeah.
Also among
I think
ourselves.
That also, yeah. So
yeah, so I think the difference is that we have always invested or done saving in fixed deposits, right? And these guys are making money out of crypto. So correct. They have enough kind of purchasing power to invest on themselves.
Touchy topic. Huh? But good metaphor. Yeah. We get the metaphor.
Yeah, yeah,
but I
yeah.
think because he's actually invested in hoping the returns stay at the moment. By the way, Hitesh, have you invested in crypto?
No, yeah. I'm I think too much invested in my own startups.
Sahi jawab in the words of Amitabh.
Good enough for risk.
Good enough. But I don't see you as a conservative person. So firstly, I don't buy that the reason for not investing is because you have that mentality of conservatism. Because that's not you. You're a guy who's basically taken the bull by the horns from start to finish from the very first venture. And you've definitely taken risks. They're all risks. If you look back, nobody would believe that it would make sense to, like you said, Indians didn't want to use a credit card. Indians didn't want to get involved in online buying. And you were able to take that risk and understand what would happen. So we should follow you, Hitesh. I feel that if you go into crypto is going to do well. We should follow you rather than the other way around.
If you're a cricket fan, check out Edges and Sledges, India's favorite cricket podcast.
The podcast focuses on Indian cricket, the IPL, and has a ton of banter both on and off the field.
We talk about the week's biggest cricket stories with current and ex-international cricketers, coaches, or sometimes just between us.
And it's hosted by me, DJ.
Me, Varun.
And me, Ashwin.
New episodes release every week.
You can catch us on the IVM Podcasts website, app,
or wherever you get your podcasts from.
Check out the Edges and Sledges Cricket Podcast.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Silvery, shall we start the AMAs?
Yes, absolutely. We have tons of AMAs for Hitesh. This first one comes in from Aditya Sharda. It's a very good question. He says, sir, with products targeted specifically to men, do you think there is an additional effort required to educate Indian men about them? What's the best way to achieve that? Like the need to have, say, lesser dark circles or to using like beard oil, et cetera, right?
Yeah, no, I completely agree. And that's what I was talking about as well. When we started out, we realized that we need to create a lot of awareness around these products as well, right? So, when we beard oil launched in 2016, so we thought it's a fancy packaging because we had a dropper and I mean, it looks very fancy, right? But after launching it, I mean, we started getting a lot of consumer feedback ki isko kaise kitne pani ke saath peena hai, because people thought that it is a homeopathy medicine and they have to kind of drink it with water, right? So we realized we need to create a lot of content around how to use these products as well, right? So, and that's what we've been doing. So if you look at even the promotion of specific products that we launch, like Under Eye Gel, I was talking about, or something else, Derma Roller, we create a lot of educational videos. And even when you're buying these products on the website, you can go through all those educational videos to see how to actually use it, how often to use it, right? And kab tak result aayega. Because these are all natural products, right? So aisa nahi hai ki you just use it today and tomorrow you'll have a beard, right? So it takes time. But we do create a lot of content to educate our customer.
You know, I had been on a flight 4-5 years back with a friend of mine, event guy called Yash. I shouldn't take his name, so I'll say it Yash, but it is Yash. Anyway, so Yash was sitting next to me and he had a beard. And the first time I saw this beard oil or gel, Joby had, you know, he applied it as we were landing. And I was making fun of him, Silvery. I, what kind of woos put stuff in his beard, etc. And then one guy from the next row started asking him questions. And immediately I realized, oh God, this is a proper market. Because the moment the guy has a beard, he totally understands ki plane ke time pe, you know, the costness of whatever has happened and he's gone through that in his head. So immediately you could see it's a winner product. And yeah, I'm thinking, what a joke, you know, because it looked a little, you know, like girlish that he takes this out and he starts doing that and that and all. But in 2 minutes, he had people asking him questions. I was amazed. That's fantastic. Do you use it yourself, sir, Hitesh?
Yes. I've been using it. I couldn't keep them dark enough. I've kind of grayed them early, but yes, I definitely use all the products.
BB ne decide kiya, obviously. You have to understand, the look is not only, it's only 20% in your command. Silvery, you use the beard products. You've discussed this, I think, once before.
Yeah, I do use beard products, yeah.
Yeah, to style the hair and gel it and all this and whatever.
So yeah, correct.
Just imagine it's a whole bloody new market. Whole new market. Hitesh is... let's take his money and invest in crypto while he's not looking. I think so. So next one.
Yeah. Next one comes from Shoik Baksi. He says, my ex loved my beard and my mom hated it. And I didn't know what to do. Did Cyrus, Hitesh, Antariksh or Rishi ever face similar issues?
Good point, Hitesh. Some parents, they do want you to look clean shaven because of work, etc. Do you have that at home?
Yeah, so I think that there are a lot of stereotypes associated with beard. So I think especially with parents, I mean, your mom never likes you to kind of keep a beard. But I think over a period of time, it has started changing. And more so because now, obviously, men have started spending a lot more effort, time on grooming their beard, right? So if it is very well kept, very well trimmed, gel, styled, it looks good, right? So now, obviously, I think things are changing. But yes, I think 5-7 years back when this trend was starting out, we used to get this complaint. Not complaint, but fear ki yaar, I want to keep it, but my mom doesn't want to let me kind of keep it. Now, I think even girlfriends and wives, they are kind of pushing you to keep a beard. So,
you can have girlfriend. You're saying we can have girlfriend and wife?
Yeah, I mean, you so can have both. We are not judging you, right? We are for every gentleman.
Yeah. So what is it? If a girlfriend wants beard and wife says no, then what do we do?
Stubble, Cyrus. That's what you're doing, Cyrus, right now.
I think that's
we get it. Silvery middle part. Hitesh to businessman. So pehli baat hai ki we have to satisfy the market. Doesn't matter who the market is. But well done, Silvery. Well played. Middle path has been appreciated. Okay, next. Let's get
Aditya Prabhakar has a very fun question. He says, what's more profitable for the man company? More clean-shaven men like Cyrus or more bearded men like Silvery? Or does it even matter? I think...
It doesn't matter. He's got for everyone, correct?
No, for everyone.
But yes, I think bearded men, because we have seen that bearded men end up buying a lot more products. So they may start with a beard oil, but then they get conscious about their looks and everything and they want to try out scrubs, sheet masks, hair styling, everything, right? So in terms of, yes, profitability, we have seen that bearded men are a lot more... profitable for us.
And such batao to, I think there's a vanity element in it also. After some time, you've kept the beard, you're looking after it. Initially, it may have been because of no work for a week or whatever. Some people, you know, come back from holiday, keep a beard. But I think after some time, everyone with a beard has a certain amount of vanity. They are looking after it from an aesthetic point of view. Mm-hmm. Silvery, I know that whatever you say, now, last 2 years, we haven't seen you without a beard. So I don't think it's going away anytime soon.
Yeah, it's not. This is my look now, man.
What does your mom say?
Mom hates it. Mom hates it. She tells me to trim it all the time. But it works with the ladies, you know, so that's what.
What? You're living alone in the Parda system with some male friend. Yeah, ladies.
It works for men also.
Unless Putsi delivery girls are coming, I don't know any other ladies who will meet you now at the moment.
Yeah.
If there's a female in the frame, you want to prove us wrong, bring the female into the frame. Come on.
And no, I don't know.
Cool.
Okay.
You're the guy with the beard, if you know what I mean.
Girish Patel asks, what kind of beard and other beauty products do you think Modi ji uses for his stage-like persona?
But that's a very good question in actuality. He's trying to be funny about it.
His beard is great. But he has a very nice beard.
And he has groomed in the last 14 to what is it now, 22, 8 years. There's a huge change in the grooming. Definitely, if you can show pictures 14 to now, a couple of pictures you can just upload quickly and show, you see the difference. Let the expert tell us. But or a controversial question bhi hoga, toh why take a chance?
No, I think, I think irrespective of anyone's opinion, I think Modi ji is one politician who probably spends on his grooming, right? Whether it's his facial hair or whatever.
I think that's taken care of.
And has got some style, right? And very, very few politicians have that.
No, but they all now, Hitesh, if I can say so, I've seen, you were talking about how the youngsters and the millennials and all these others are now into this whole looking good factor, but also the politicians, they've changed completely. They are grooming, they're watching their hairstyles, they're watching their weight. BJP especially has made sure a lot of them have lost weight. They've made a conscious effort. I'm sure we can find out from the inner circles. They've made a conscious effort to keep these guys trim, bring down their weight, make them look, from Nitin Gadkari onwards, you can go down the rank and file and you'll see that they have made that effort. And I'm sure the other parties are also copying it now. So your market includes everyone. That's the fabulous thing about this business of ours, yaar. Kahan se, kaise bhi, I mean, they all come into the net at some point.
From 16 to 60, so everyone.
And also the importance of when you're a prime minister or something, a telegenic appeal, even the Americans, I would say, have taught all of us this because they're very careful about visual content and how they look, etc. And I think that they take it very seriously now. So your products are very important because everybody's aging, first and foremost.
Yeah. No, I think more than aging, yes, everyone wants to look good, right? I mean, in front of cameras and everyone is either on the news channel or...
Exactly. Sorry. So, who do you think is the best politician in terms of grooming that you've seen out of the ones we are aware of? Like, say, Shashi Tharoor, his hair is fantastic.
I think Shashi Tharoor is very well groomed. And I think there's quite a few of them here. So, Modi ji definitely is one of them. Then, even I think Mr. Sindhya is kind of pretty well groomed.
Fabulous, yeah. He's a good looking guy. He's done well. Yeah. So, I'm saying it.
quite a few of them, yeah. I think most of the young guys, I think they're kind of well-groomed.
See that, Silvery? It's a visual medium now. You can't get away. In the old days, they would do an AIR broadcast or something. You don't know who the guy is. But today, even a Harsha Bogle, everybody has to look good. So, they all groom well and take care of themselves. Except aging VJs, like that, whatever her name is. Chalo, agla sawal.
So, yeah. Sure. Next one comes from Bruce Wayne. We already kind of talked about this, but his question is, Bollywood hero of my youth was a chikna ladka, clean shaven with middle parting. Uncles and villains had facial hair. Now I see an epidemic of pointed beards and pompadours in Indian men. Why do you think that is?
Yeah, up to Shah Rukh, you can say. And then after that, I would say that this Ranbir onwards, it's all over the place, right? These trends are important because they define a lot of, you go to the Hajam, you'll see the posters, you'll know what the trend is that's working. But let the expert tell us. Hitesh, what do you think? From Chikna
I think last 6-7 years, yes, I think everyone is kind of keeping a beard, right? Anyone who gets good facial hair is keeping a beard. So Shah Rukh probably is not keeping it because he gets that patchy beard, but I mean, otherwise everyone
else. Pathan or whatever, this one, there is finally. But by and large, his appeal was that whatever, boy next door, clean shaven, sort of, but I think that's also changed.
So, I think there were a lot of stereotypes. Like I mentioned, there were a lot of stereotypes associated with beard as such, right? And this is, I think, one of these stereotypes which was associated ki yaar, agar aapki beard hai, toh aap gunde ho, right? Ya aapke paas kuch kaam nahi hai. Ya aap artist
ho. MacMohan. MacMohan. Ka villain.
Exactly.
There was. Clearly, the villain had the beard. Amjad Khan's character in many films always with beard in that sense.
Exactly.
So, he's right.
So, it was probably used to kind of differentiate between heroes and villains, right? Now I think things have changed. I think thanks to Virat Kohli and Ranveer Singh and all these guys, I think they've got the trend back.
Virat, though, if you ever see his old pictures with clean shaven, exactly like you, he's a good Punjabi boy, exactly like you, fat face in the young pictures, and then he lost a lot of weight and he's got this beard. It's like you won't even recognize him. I've put the two pictures up. You won't. Can we show your picture? The Kohliization of men. Well done, Girish. Superb.
You want the clean shaven one?
Yeah. The clean shaven, it's a 2011, you can go to. And yours also. Let Hitesh judge. He'll tell us how much better your look with the beard.
Okay, I'll have to find it. But I'll ask you a question in the meantime and then I'll find my thing. Shovik Bakshi asks, an old ad of An A-list Bollywood actor surfaced online and went viral, where he said, growing long hair, wearing pink and purple, and holding hands is not manly. Views?
Wow. But who's the actor? Let's first find out the gossip.
Okay, let's find that out.
Yeah, no, I know the name of the actor as well. I am not sure if I'm okay to... So Sanjay Dutt did this ad for a liquor brand.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But that's okay. It's a little... Yeah, you know,
look, I think everyone has their opinion and we need to respect that, right? I mean,
my father and that generation, a lot of men would have said the same thing about men shouldn't have long hair and pink and purple, 100%. Holding hands, 100% not. Yeah. But here he's been paid money to say it. So I always say when you paid money to say it, doesn't mean that's what you want to say. We have done a lot of stupid things with when they've paid us money. Let me be honest.
Yeah, but wasn't Sanjay Dutt the first one to start this growing long hair?
Long hair. Yeah. Well, not first.
Khalnayak,
yes.
I think he was the first.
Okay, didn't Kumar Gaurav have long hair for a little while? No, not really. Okay, you're right. Maybe it was Sanjay Dutt. So he didn't bother to check.
and he's the brand ambassador for a men fashion accessory brand as well, right? So
yeah, there you go.
But anyways,
paisa bolta hai. But look, this is the way it was. But I think today, and you proved it with your entire, you opened an industry where it's not like you're saying no to what he said also. I'm sure if you see the market there, there'll be pink and purple clothes for men. If that's something that the market wants. Am I right, Hitesh?
Yeah.
You'll never get into the
Definitely. We are not judging you, right? I mean, irrespective of whatever your opinion is. I mean, we are there for you.
He's feeling shy, sharam ki baat hai, so I'll speak for him. Silvery wants one pink shirt and one purple pant, if it's possible, as in when. Huh?
Yeah,
Silvery,
sure.
Not paying attention, free clothes. Fair enough.
I'll take free clothes, pink shirt.
Old uncles are talking, you don't have to pay attention. Leave it, chalo.
Okay.
Picture dena.
Yeah, I'm trying to find it. Okay. I'll find it. I'll just
cool. Next question till then.
Yeah. Next one comes from Hitesh. He says, comes from Vineet. He says, Hitesh, apart from solving...
Hitesh, he's on some narcotic substance. I'm trying to stop him. I don't know why this is happening every day on the show. Yeah. Hitesh, this question comes from Hitesh. Bolo.
Vineet says, Hitesh, apart from solving a problem better, does simply increasing the valuation of business ever come to your mind while decision making?
Yeah, so I think good question. Valuation is dependent on a lot of things, right? The growth rate, the scale of business, how strong the brand is, right? So it is not just one thing. When you make any decision in the business, it is for the betterment of business. And I think it is an effort to grow the business from X to Y, right? Now, whether valuation increases because of that, is a result, is an output, right? But I think as a brand, as an entrepreneur, I focus on strategy, and I believe strategy is more about inputs than output, right? And valuation is an output. So whatever we decide is more as an input, how to kind of accelerate the growth of the business, how to increase the profitability, how to make new products work, how to launch an interesting campaign which kind of connects with our consumer. Now, as a result, if valuation goes up, is an after effect, right? So not in our hand.
Well, let's put it this way, Vineet, I don't think Hitesh would like to say it himself, but valuation always goes up. If you follow his career, it's almost without fail. And again, you aren't going to say that, but Hitesh, you're able to smell what the thing is. You know, that's the difference, ultimately, between you and all the other entrepreneurs, the ones that can be successful. You're able to tell. You're just able to tell that this is working and this will work. Or if it doesn't work, you'll pull it out quickly and move on to the next. So I feel there's got to be some talent involved, which people are not talking about. Otherwise, everybody will be a successful entrepreneur.
No, thanks. I think it is all about staying connected with the consumer, right? And you keep on getting so many insights, and you just need to catch hold of one insight. Some things work, a lot of things don't work, right? And I think people probably see the thing that has worked, but there are so many things that also doesn't work, right? So like they say, I mean, everyone celebrates your success, but no one celebrates the journey, right? So I think even to kind of like dating app in India, breaking so many stereotypes was not an easy, right? And we made a true effort, but still I think Tinder kind of came in and kind of disrupted the market completely, right? And casual dating, hookup, even in India, right, became a norm. So
in loki kuch morals nahi hai, iske liye yaar. These youngsters are disregarding morality, and you know, that is why we should really, Silvery, how dare you behave like this? See, Silvery, he's not on the podcast, he's on something, he's on Insta. You were right, he's busy sending things.
I'm how trying to find a clean shaven photo of myself. If you
okay, the question, I'll do it while you search. How did you come up with the name, The Man Company? Very interesting. You should have asked this. Good anchor would have, but generally, thanks for joining in. These are always interesting things. Why? And it's simple, it's straightforward, and it's bang on. So obviously, how did you get that?
Yeah. Look, so I think easier answer is we could get the domain name, but I think what we really liked about the name is because we wanted to focus a lot on content and community to build this brand, right? And we realized that with the name, the Man Company, you get the sense of gentlemen's club or a community, right? Strong community, directly talking to men, right? So wo usme vibe matlab naam mein, so we had few more alternatives, but then we realized that this brand, one, straightforward, like you mentioned, good recall, and then a sense of community, right, which comes from the brand name. So that's what made us kind of go after it.
Also, let me ask this question, and for I'm sure Janelle is thinking the same thing. What would have been a couple of options that you didn't take? You must have had a few more in your head and with the guys around you. So, kya finals mein finalists kaun the?
Yeah. So, honestly, I don't remember all the names, but there were 3-4 more options. But I think someone had a shaving or something to do with beard, right? And we wanted to kind of stay away from a specific product.
Correct.
Or a specific segment. We wanted to create a lifestyle brand which is head to toe, right? So tomorrow, if even we want to expand the brand into some other category focusing on men, we can do that, right? So it's a very, very generalist name in that sense.
Beard and more. That could have been one, because beard was a strong component, but you didn't want to get pigeonholed. I understand totally. Yeah. Let's go back to the young man named after silver. Antariksh, with hiring, this is Vineet again. I've seen whenever I've interviewed clean shaven, good, this is a great point, and bright colored shirt, I get a positive thing. While with stubble and corporate colored shirt, I got negative response. At least initially, maybe it doesn't affect and the whole thing because they study the biodata, etc. But initially, do people get turned off you when you're going for a job interview because you're slightly unshaven and with a strange looking shirt?
Again, I think they're very subjective. I agree. I think probably 10 years back, yes. I mean, 5-6 years back, yes. I think it was a perception. Even like, I mean, till a couple of years back in most of the leading, let's say, banks, you're not supposed to keep a beard, right? I mean, you're supposed to be clean shaven and always informal. But now I think things have started to change, right? Companies like EY, PwC, I mean, which used to kind of mandate people to have a clean shave. But now I think they've also relaxed their policy and you can keep a beard if you want to. So,
wow. But all said and done, I for my generation, I wouldn't have the confidence of going for a job interview, I think, with stubble and all that. I think that would take I'm just thinking back, if I was a young boy going to get a job interview, the way we were raised, the clothes would be clean, neat. It would be sober colors for sure. And clean shaven, hair in place. Generally, that would have been up to the 90s. I would presume that would have been the case.
Yeah.
Someone coming to your company?
No, I completely agree. So even today, right? I mean, you expect the candidate to be well groomed. Now, shaved or beard is one thing. I mean, if you have a unkempt beard, right, which is not groomed properly, you get the same impression, right? I mean, even if I don't have any bias for bearded guys, but still I would have the same impression. So I think what is important is that you have to be groomed, whether you are shaved or beard, but you have to be well groomed, right? I think that's the bottom line. And same goes with clothes, right? I mean, obviously, if you're going for an interview, I mean, you need to wear proper shirt or whatever, right? I mean, it's okay. And depending on where you're going, right? I mean, obviously, I think with startups, I mean, even if you turn up in t-shirt and shorts, it is absolutely okay, right? As long as you're capable and have the
for
right
the man attitude. Company, if Silvery comes dressed like this, green, check shirt, slightly open,
doesn't matter.
Hair in place, is he correct? And he's got a beard, he's groomed it.
Doesn't matter. We don't give any weightage to the looks.
Oh, damn good, yeah. That's a great point for you, Silvery. Please keep in mind,
yeah,
man company.
Thank God. Yeah. So I got this, Cyrus. You want a photo of me without a beard.
Wow.
That's the red. The one in red is me.
Yeah, I know. I'm just thinking. Yeah, take the mask off so we can see you.
Yeah, correct.
But this is weight up or weight down? I can't tell.
As in?
Your weight is up or down in this? Down.
This one is down. In this one, I'm the one on the left, as you can see.
Yeah.
But a very weird photo.
And that's your boyfriend. One. Yeah.
Yeah, correct. This is the couple I do things with. And
Right. Okay. All right. Yeah, don't tell us anything more. It's the man company.
And that's after I'm done with everything. I'm very happy. So that's what,
yeah. Let Hitesh judge. Hitesh, with beard or without beard?
With beard, man.
No, I think both. That long as such, right? I mean, probably 2-3 years back, no?
Actually, 6-7 years back. But thanks so much. It? That is, wow. That's like, yeah.
Okay, don't
that's
show
like calling off. me my dad, my brother. You know that.
Kuch bhi hai, kuch bhi hoga. In 5 or 10 or 15 years, you'll see it all catches up. Don't worry. Don't sure, don't sure. brag. Wait till you cross 40. Okay. All right. This has been a great interview, Silvery.
Yep.
Yes, should we end it here? Because Hitesh has to make money, unlike us. He can't waste his time talking to idiots who one can't grow beard and the other is not even bothered to trim it properly. Hitesh, honestly, a lot of respect. Great having you on the show. And let's hope to have you back because you're the expert for us now on the men with the man company. Will there be a woman company?
It's been absolute pleasure. Yeah.
Woman company in the future?
Hopefully. Yes.
No, I meant I think company of women. The right time.
Company of women, yeah. So we may not name it women company, but yes, I mean, why not?
I like this brand, company of women. Silvery, are you on board?
Yeah, absolutely. Company of women.
Coming soon. Hitesh has promised. Chalo. All right.
Thanks.
Cheers,
thanks,
guys. Yeah. Have a great day, everybody.
Thank you.
See you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter on Cyrus Says In, or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Do you like true crime stories? Do you like to learn about the people behind some horrible, awful crimes? More specifically, women that may have committed these crimes. Actually, Indian criminals that are women? Then we'd like to welcome you to our podcast, Misconduct. My name is Raghavi. And I am Nisha. We cover themes like murder, dacoity, drug trafficking, financial fraud, kidnapping, and many more. You can catch us every Wednesday on the IVM Podcast Network or wherever you get your podcast.
A wise man once said, traveling, it makes you speechless, then turns you into a storyteller.
Well, listen to such travel stories and experiences exploring India on the Musafir Stories with us, Saif and Faiza.
Catch us on the IVM website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.